Hi guys, this is Ravikram. Welcome back to my channel. And today I am back with another bike that is Royal Enfield Meteor 350. So today we are going to do the quick review of this new bike. So in this video, I am going to tell you what are the main features this bike has, its specifications and on-road price. So each and everything I will be covering up in this video. So do watch the video till the end. And if you are new to my channel or watching my videos for the first time, please click subscribe button and turn on notifications so that you will get my updates immediately when I upload a video. So without getting late, let's get into the video. This is the all new Royal Enfield Meteor 350cc. In terms of technicality, this bike has 349cc, which produces 20.4 PS power at 27 Nm of torque. So this is just the basic engine figures. Basically, this has air-cooled engine and it has SOHC, and the parts are mostly reduced when compared with the previous model. So this is now very compact engine, and due to its compact engine, collection of parts, now this has less vibrations. So if you compare this particular vehicle with this previous Thunderbolt, the vibrations are fairly reduced. And let's talk about the front design. Even if you can see the front visor, this is a Supernova model. The current model which you are looking is Supernova. There are three models in this. One is Fireball, two is Stellar, and three is Supernova. So there are actually three stages. The basic is Fireball. So the middle one is Stellar, and the top end, the particular now which you are looking, the blue color, is a Supernova model. So in this you get this big visor, and this is also adjustable. And if you can see these screws, if you loosen this and pull this visor up, the visor can be adjusted as per your rider's choice. And coming to the main headlamp, this is an LED DRL with halogen, regular halogen unit. Everybody used to have a projector in it, but they have removed that. So basically, this is an upgraded version of Thunderbolt. Coming to the suspension, this bike has 41mm telescopic suspension. So you don't get any USB forks in it. So all the cruisers will get telescopic suspension, which are basically standard across all cruiser bikes. And they are actually 41mm, which are big. They provide good amount of suspension travel as well. And coming to the wheel section, you got 19-inch wheels at the front and 17-inch wheels at the back. And coming to the tire section, on the front you got 100x90 19-inch wheels, which are from Seat, 40x70 17-inch at the rear. So basically, on the front you got 19-inch and at the rear 17-inch. So previous model used to have 18-inch wheel at the back, but they have downsized to 17-inch wheel. And this bike has 300mm front big disc with dual channel ABS, and rear 270mm, which is really big for this particular vehicle. Fuel tank capacity of this vehicle is 15 liters. The previous model used to get 20, but they have downsized to 15 liters. So the average economy is also expected somewhere around 35 kilometers per liter. So company claimed to be 41, but we can expect a mileage somewhere around 35, but that also depends upon your riding conditions. And if you can see the rear suspension, you got twin shock absorbers at the rear, and this is also 6-step adjustable, and the suspension is little bit on harder side. And you got dual channel ABS unit, stainless steel exhaust, Meteor logo on the side panels. And coming to the back side, you can see the Royal Enfield logo. This is a back crest actually. So if you consider buying this particular Supernova model, you'll get that back crest as standard along with the visor. So the seat is also a little bit low. So the persons who are around 5'4 to 5'5 can easily access this vehicle. Each and every place there is a Royal Enfield branding on each and every side, foot peg, the backrest, as well as side panels. And one thing you have to notice, the logo is totally changed. And this bike has 5-speed transmission, and you don't have any slipper clutch on it, so the clutch is little bit on harder side. And the quality of clutch lever as well as brake lever are pretty high, so these are actually very bulky, and they also provide you good feel when you pull the levers. And coming to the left side handlebar, you got the different type of switch knob. So regularly you used to get switches type, but you got this round color dial where you have low beam, high beam and pass in one switch. And this is for indicators, and this is for a horn. And if you can see the back side, there is a I button, which means if you press the I button, the information on the screen will be changed. On the right side, you can see engine kill switch and self start button, as well as hazard light switch. So the hazard light switch is standard on this vehicle, so there is no need to install any aftermarket hazard light for this vehicle. And the quality of this brake fluid reservoir is also pretty decent. And let me show you the instrumentation cluster. So this is the screen for navigation display as well as Bluetooth connectivity. So in let me turn it on. So this is how it boots up. On the left side you have speedometer in kilometers per hour and miles per hour, and on the center screen you got odometer, and if you click the I button, the information will be changed like trip A, trip B and odometer. That's it. And you don't get any range indicator in this. You got fuel indicator, gear indicator and eco light, time. So this is the basic information this bike provides, and this is little bit loose. I don't know why it is like this. And let me show you the DRL. DRL is turned on and this is how it looks. So the outside round color light is the DRL and this is the regular halogen unit. Here tail light also looks same like in front LED DRL, the round color, the ring light, and indicators are all basic. And let me turn on the engine. These are some basic features of this Royal Enfield Meteor 350cc. And coming to its weight, this bike has an core weight of 191 kgs, which is actually heavy when compared with its competitors. Like the Honda Hi-Ness has 181 kgs and this one has 191 kgs. You can feel the weight when it is stopped in traffic conditions, but once you move on you can't feel that much of weight. And there are actually advantages and disadvantages for this weight issues. The ground clearance of this vehicle is 170 mm, which means if you take this bike in potholes or any high speed breakers, so you need to slow down because there are chances of hitting the underground base plate. So you have to be little bit careful for this vehicle. And one more thing I have to tell you, this bike is customizable. So this bike can be customized as per your choice. There is an application from Royal Enfield, so you can go to the application and customize the whole vehicle. Like you can modify the vehicle like usually you do in the video games. So the same thing you can do for this particular vehicle. Each and every part can be customized and take the delivery from the factory itself. So this is one of the coolest thing. And if you want to know about the navigation system as well as demonstration of customizing the particular Royal Enfield Meteor 350 bike, you can comment me in the comment section. So most of the people wants me to make a video, then definitely I'll make a dedicated video on it. So do let me know in the comment section. And coming to its main pricing, this bike is priced at ₹2,20,000 for this particular Supernova model. So there are actually three models which I told you before. So this bike range starts from 2 lakhs to 2,20,000, and each and everything is customizable. So if you keep on adding the accessories, the prices will be increased. So the on-ride rough price would be 2 lakhs to 12,20,000 for Royal Enfield Meteor 350, and these are the on-road prices. And this on-road prices will be changed depending upon your current location. It's all about the Royal Enfield Meteor 350, and a dedicated ride review will be coming up next. Stay tuned for that. And if you want to talk to me, you can message me on Instagram, and those are new to my channel or you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please subscribe to my channel, turn on notifications so that you will get my updates when I upload a video. And a little amount of support is also needed from your side. And if you guys support me, I can make more videos like this. So keep supporting me. This is Ravi Kiran signing off.